I find extremely peaceful, walking the woods and being able to do it so easily like you can in Marin County.
I like Singletrack because it goes around obstacles, it's challenging, it's fast, it's flowing, it's just much more interesting than being on this big, wide, open road. You're really with nature.
If a mountain bike was coming on the trail right now towards us, we would have to jump to the side really fast.
I had an incident with a gentleman who had left a 39-foot skid mark.
You know, some of these other guys could get back up in here and tear things up. You have to be courteous, is the bottom line, you know, otherwise it gets really dangerous.
They were coming down way too fast, and I had to just stop on my way up here. There's about six of them. I don't know which way to run to.
There's a lot of turf war here.
We've been yelled at a couple of times.
Well, there's people who put wires up on some of the illegal trails that bikers hit.
Singletrack is the essence of our sport, the original euphoria. You know what I'm all talking about. It hasn't changed. People live for this experience.
No, it doesn't solve a problem by giving one or two narrow trails up to bicycling, because then what happens is bicyclers will go, if I can use that one, I'm going to use this one, and I'm going to use that one.
Certainly things could have gone differently. Certainly the mountain bike could have been embraced as, a wonderful machine. But it didn't happen. And, you know, I'm not quite sure what we could have done differently.
You know, we're fighting over paradise.
I'm Jim Bonzi. I'm the chairman of the Marin Group Outings Committee of the Sierra Club, and I lead hikes also for the Marin Group Sierra Club. And I've been doing this for over 30 years. Well, this is a single track trail, which means it's about enough size for maybe one person to walk along, or two people if they scoot over to the side can pass each other. So it's a pretty narrow trail. And this is true of a lot of trails on Mount Tam, it's just single track, but there's also a lot of fire roads.
People used to come over on weekends from San Francisco on excursions. And as the story goes, there's a hiking group here. And they were horrified to see a couple of hunters dressing a deer. It really upset them. And they decided to try and protect this area and make it into a conservation area. They were instrumental in actually purchasing a lot of this land, which were then given to the state, especially towards the top of the mountain, in the 1930s, and the state park was formed.
Mount Tam is the largest geographic feature in Marin County. This county is something like, 65-70% of the county is preserved in parks or open space or water district land. So it's a large sense that this is a special place. A lot of the trails on Mount Tam, especially, were built by some of the early hiking clubs. The Town Pies Conservation Club, for instance, they've got built a lot of the trails back in the 19-teens and 20s. So most of the trails built on Mount Tam were built way before mountain bikes were even thought of.
This bike I rode a lot. You know, it was a... set the repack record on this sucker, man, and rode in Colorado on this little devil, and it broke a couple of times down here, and I'd braze it together and it'd crack again, and I said, okay, time to get a different frame. That's the thing, I mean, these weren't made out of the greatest grade of steel, you know, it wasn't chromoly and anything, but the frame design was rather good. We thought so much the world of this frame geometry that all the first Bruisers, all the first Richies, everything, you know, the first Fisher bikes were, until like about 82, 83, were all exactly this geometry. It was really funny. We're so afraid of doing something new and different.
When I first started riding off-road, it was like 73. People were riding all kinds of stuff. There weren't too many riders, and there weren't too many hikers. There was barely anybody out there. The holy place was Mount Tamalpais. I mean, it was our turf in a lot of ways.
We had town bikes, just, you know, one speed, coaster brake, because you don't want to ride your fancy Italian bike down to the grocery store. So we had some town bikes, and Marin County, as you certainly know, is full of dirt roads, and eventually we ventured out on them, and we kept doing that, and the rides just kept getting more and more people.
There were these clans of riders at the time in Fairfax, San Anselmo, in Larkspur Canyon, in Tiburon, in Mill Valley, and everybody claimed they were hot stuff. So my roommate at the time, Charlie Kelly, got the bright idea of like, hey, let's do a race.
Yeah, I don't know if you've been on a mountain bike ride, but you probably have. When you get to the top of the hill, no one says go, but everybody races. What's the deal there, you know? And the thing about you can't really race on a single track if you're in a group, because whoever gets in front stays in front. Eventually we came to the idea, hey, let's just run against the clocks down this road that we use, that's a really good test, and we'll find out once and for all who's the fastest in our little group of five or six people.
From where I'm standing, you can see part of San Geronimo Ridge, and you can actually gain access to that ridge from here, and you can ride along that ridge to the top of Repack. Repack was almost 2 miles straight down vertical descent, which started out kind of low-key, and it evolved into something where there were people coming from as far away as Berkeley and parts of the East Bay and Sonoma County. Word spread pretty rapidly, and for the most part it was 98% guys trying to outdo each other speed-wise, and it was just a hairball experience.
This was 1978 Repack, and I was one of the few people that wore knee pads and elbow pads because I was a skateboarder and I had all that stuff. And this is the Joe Breeze's second bike that he built, because he got the first one. And you know, that's Repack. That's one of the better photos anyone ever took of me riding out there. So it goes on my website and in my scrapbook and everywhere else if I can put it. So. Yeah, souvenirs. Don't you have some?
There was a TV show there that happened. They called us up and said, hey, we've heard about this thing and we want to come out and do it. Well, it was Evening Magazine. It was KPIX. And they actually won an award that year for that particular segment. It was so well done. And it was shown nationwide. Oh my God. You know, it started to put the whole thing on the map.
The history of the conflict and trail use here really goes back into the 80s when mountain biking started to catch on a little bit. And in the beginning you had so few, there was no impact whatsoever. But as the sport grew, the impact began to get noticed by people who liked to go out for nice hikes, nice quiet hikes on the trails, and they'd have bikes coming by them. Really, you just had a lot of people that started to complain about the activity, and so the land managers started to take notice.
There's a lot of very established environmental pioneers in this county that have brought us the Golden Gate Recreation Area, Point Reyes, Mount Tamalpais State Park, to name only some of the areas that they've been able to protect. And that generation in particular, the people that did bring the big acreages into open space, those people feel extremely protective of the resource.
Marin County is such a well-controlled place. It's wonderful and it's horrible at the same time. Mountain biking was considered to be, environmentally incorrect. It create erosion. This county too, we don't like the idea of people coming over from the East Bay or from San Francisco or something and clogging our streets and stealing our children and, you know, and doing all these horrible things that outsiders could do. And certainly, you don't want them sullying up our trails on a mountain bike. Oh my goodness. So you go into the meeting room and it's like radio. Anyone that can get a really good story going, they win. They create the visualizations and that's who wins. And our people, well, arguably they weren't as articulate as the other side.
I don't want to give it this dignity, but it's just like what happens in battles over civil rights. The people that think that they're being wronged, and the bikers would, have nothing but anger, and they would come and pack the chambers of the supervisors, screaming, yelling, etc. Now, the interesting thing was that they played that all wrong, because that was the antithesis of the otherwise users of the park, of the parks or open space, you know what I mean? They just mosey along, you know. So they were all gentle folks, and these people would come in shrieking. They would almost, they were the caricature of the criticism that people had of them, if you know what I mean. And they would say, we're going to get you in elections, and we're going to do this, and we're going to do that. Well, I cannot tell you how off-register that was. First, they were newcomers in every sense of the word. And so to do a confrontation like that and say, so what happens? The answer is you lose.
As far as the number of violations, I would say somewhere between 100 to 150 per year for bicycle use. Some of it was illegal trail use, others was speed. People had ignored our regulations and ultimately had their bikes taken away.
People want to build a trail, probably because they felt that they wanted to go on single track trails and there weren't enough open for them.
The day that we were indicted, we were facing $600,000 fines and 33 years in jail. I was charged with three felonies. They gave me an additional felony because they say I was chopping down a tree. That was the small one. The two were destruction of federal property and conspiracy. They had me on conspiracy. They said there was a whole bunch of us and, you're not telling us, so we're gonna haul you in on conspiracy.
Marin was one of the first places we were writing about because it was probably the first really fucked up access problem. Nowhere else really has the same percentage of population that are cyclists or has the same amount of public land right out their doorstep that they're not allowed to use. And so, it just became a flashpoint early. And it's also, technically it's the birthplace of the sport. It's where people first figured out what they were doing on bikes. Just to shut people down because they happen to be the last use group in is really short-term thinking. A generation from now, what are young people gonna do?
Grant and I, we were riding over down near Royce Redwoods area on some single track. Well, we actually didn't get to the single track yet, but a ranger stopped us and told us we couldn't do that. folks, and he said he might have given us a ticket.
If he wasn't nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. We started this in Christmas break, this December. As you can see, we've built a lot. I don't know, we've been able to come out almost every weekend and work for at least 5 or 10 hours a weekend.
Yeah.
Usually at night.
We put lots of time into this place.
This is built not connected with hiking or other use trails on private land, but say, like right off a hiking trail on public land, we built this, I think that would be highly irresponsible. Because doing this with public land, where it's everyone's and it's, you know, no group can just unilaterally just go out and, you know, do whatever, I think that would be very damaging.
We've tried the best we can to make this as non-damaging as possible. This is all built using recycled non-treated wood. We've used vinyl dip nails instead of galvanized nails, which harm the environment.
We haven't put any nails into trees at all anywhere. It's all freestanding supports or using already dead stumps as supports. There's pretty much only 3 trails in the entire county that you can actually ride legally.
Tamarancho and China. Those are the only legal.
There's also a trail out in Lucas Valley on George Lucas's, it's one of George Lucas's conservation easements, and they built a multi-use trail open to bikes there.
That's like wide.
Yeah. I mean, that's pretty fun to come down, I guess. it's nice that it's legal, you know, you can't get yelled at.
Ideally, I guess if we were as free as people are in British Columbia, we could spend time like this and integrate it into some trails around here.
I think mountain bikers need a bell. That would solve all the problems. Instead of saying, on your right, on your left, you're confused by that because you don't know what they're talking about.
My name is Jim Jacobson. I'm the president of the Bicycle Trails Council of Marin. We've been advocating for single track for years for bicyclists, and the county open space and the water district and all that weren't too forthcoming in giving us that, so we approached the Boy Scouts, and they said fine. So 6 years later, 10,000 hours of volunteer time later, we have an 8-mile trail. What you find is around the country, there are a few areas that have conflict between bicyclists and anti-bicyclists, hikers, typically, frequently equestrians, that don't want to share the trails. Marin County is one of these areas. In Marin County, if you complain about bikes, you are rewarded that managers will close trails. So it's a successful strategy for those people that don't want to share. I can't totally understand it, but I see it on a national basis. And it's ironic that the areas with the problems are the areas where they try over hard to control it. That's one of the reasons we built the system out here at Tamarancho, is to have a place for bicyclists to use where they're welcome and it's designed for them. And now it worked very well. And there's a whole lot less illegal single track use in Marin County since Tamarancho has been built and available for use.
This weed is from Europe, it's not native, and it's just eating everything. So we're just taking out the weed so it won't kill the native plants. There's a lot of work into maintaining these trails in Tamarancho, and it's a paradise to be able to ride legally single tracks in Marin. And these trails are just awesome. So it's like a change from the boring fire roads. Sometimes it's great to have something challenging to ride.
A lot of sudden oak death here. This was last week, this was all cut up. Unfortunately, this tr- tree here was one of the just the gorgeous aspects of this trail. It was three or four.
Howdy.
Hi. Come here. We had three or four huge limbs that were crossing this trail at slightly above head height. It was just kind of a like going through a cave to go under in this area. So. Sudden oak.
At China Camp, which became a state park about 25, 30 years ago, the trails there were built with mountain bikes in mind. They wanted to have a multi-use trail system and give it a try. Mountain bikes were just becoming popular back then, and the mountain bike community and the state park said, let's work together on this. And they did. They built trails with trail machines, and they had them very nice slopes so that they are not really steep slopes. So going up or coming down is not a big problem. They're wide enough for a horseback rider and a hiker, or a bicyclist and a hiker, to pass with no problem at all.
China Camp's a classic example where basically bikes can go on single track trails. And actually, this has created real controversy for hikers because a lot of them just avoid China Camp because they keep having clashes with the bike people because they're on these narrow trails and they keep running into them.
China Camp, I don't usually come at weekends because there's so many bikers. And I choose the trail, I go up one side where there are no bikes. And then I make a decision about whether I go down the bike trail one or not. But they do move. I mean, it's like, I don't know how they do it. It scares me. And I understand for them, it's the weekends are the best time. So it's I don't know what to do about it, you know. I can choose other places.
What public agencies fail to understand is the wider trails produce more speed problems. And they're actually setting up a situation, in my opinion, where they're more likely to get complaints about us and the trail's more threatened with being shut down due to complaints because of their insistence on the trail being 5 foot wide. The trails that are this wide, this is like, what is this? This is like 30 inches. This is 24 to 30 inches wide. It's very hard to go fast on this trail. You'll fall off it.
The theory has been, if you give us a few trails, we'll be happy. Well, that's happened, but it hasn't worked. China Camp is the example we kept citing. The problem with China Camp is that you have an entire ridgeline, and China Camp was opened up, beautiful, wonderful, everyone was excited about it. This is the big opportunity, but what's happened now is that the entire ridge is covered with a spider web of illegal trails. They cause a lot of erosion because what the bicycles will tend to do is run straight down a ridge. It opens up erosion, it will open up landslides, it causes all sorts of other problems.
There's a lot of evidence to suggest that mountain bikes are digging their own graves because the way we perpetuate ourselves in the media, and being part of the media, I'm part of that problem. We uphold this standard and this kind of the extreme now generation that is just, it's throughout media, it's every sport. Everyone wants to, you know, take it to 11, to go further. And so when people see mountain bikes, they think of people jumping off cliffs, because that's what the media perpetuates. We're part of that problem, but for us, it's also, we have to kind of be looking at where people are pushing boundaries. Most people don't do that. Most people are content to ride around the block, but that doesn't sell magazines, that doesn't, you know, it doesn't make movies. And that's a huge problem that we face because that's what people will use as ammo against us. Most of the people who want to close a trail down can hold up a picture of our magazine and say, look, here's a guy skidding down a cliff. This is environmentally incorrect behavior.
I think that the hardest thing facing mountain biking is an image. And the Marin County represents one of the most challenging places to upgrade our image, but it also will represent one of the most valuable things that we can do is to establish our legitimacy in this county. And we have to upgrade our image, and we have to be not seen as just tearing up the place, be it my generation or the next two generations. I think legitimate trail activities will ultimately get us more trail. And I think a lot of us have begun to realize that.
If everyone would have all this time shown courtesy to other people, we wouldn't be here today. You wouldn't be taping today. But it's this testosterone driven mentality that has really created most of the problems. Because it's really about personal desire. I want to be able to ride wherever I want. I want to be able to be here. It's so far beyond that we try to take it several levels above that to just how do we protect the environment? This little postage stamp, a little very valuable postage stamp of the environment for future generations.
I don't think everything should be opened up. I think some single track trail that exists should be opened up. Some should be left hiker only. And then there should be some new stuff. There should be some new things built.
I sort of think that there should be discrete trails, but I don't believe it's possible now because everybody's hugely territorial about it all, right? I can't imagine bikers giving up an ounce of a trail that they now have possession to. And I can't imagine the other users voluntarily yielding theirs. Do you know what I mean? I just can't see it. But it's not near as pleasant anymore in the open spaces as it was. And I don't know that there's a way to come off of that. I mean, you can see it in the way people walk, and the way they look, they're all suspicious and looking around to see what's going to happen next. It's sort of sad. It used to be, ho, 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 everybody's having this great time. Now there is a tension on some of these places and some of these trails. I mean, maybe it's inevitable, I don't know.
Okay, that's painless. I'm okay. I survived, yeah.